Sarah Imenu said to Avram, Yishpat Hashem beini ubeinecha, let Hashem be the judge. Sarah felt that Hagar was mocking, was acting with scorn, and apparently on some level Sarah felt that Avram did not stand up for her honor, and she said to Avram, let us go in front of Hashem for a din Torah, let Hashem be the judge. The Midrash tells us that while Sarah may have been correct in her assessment, because she said those words, she lost 28 years of her life, because Hashem judged her with din, and therefore she died 28 years earlier than she should have. This Midrash is difficult to understand. Why, just because Sarah said, let us enter in din, did she lose 28 years of her life? And I think the answer to this question is based on understanding the systems of judgment and the systems that Hashem created to run the world. When Hashem created the physical worlds, Hashem created immutable laws of nature. Gases tend to expand. Heat tends to rise. Heavy objects tend to fall. Those are laws that govern all of physicality throughout the cosmos. Those laws are neither kind nor sweet. Those laws are reality. As Hashem created the physical world with laws, so too Hashem created the upper world, the world of man, and the world of the malachim with laws. One of those laws is din. Din literally means justice. What you did, you're held accountable for. If you did X and through that came Y, you're responsible, you're accountable for what came out from your actions. The problem is that din is very exacting and very demanding. Din says, if you did this, you are held 100% totally accountable for what you did. And the Mesillat Yesharim explained to us that if din were in operation, no human being would last very long, because a human being's potential is so phenomenal and a human being's actions are so impactful that if a human being were ever held to extreme din, he wouldn't last very long. The punishment would be instant death and humanity wouldn't exist. If it could be, Hashem thought to create the world with Midas Hadin, but saw that din alone couldn't exist, and therefore Hashem introduced rachamim. Rachamim is mercy, and mercy means there are mitigating circumstances, mitigating factors. Yes, he did X, which brought about Y, but you have to understand, look at where he's coming from, understand his perspective, and see where he was at the time. Throughout our existence, din and rachamim exist. Both are in operation, but mercy always mitigates the din, and in that sense, we're not held fully accountable. What Sarah Imenu was saying to Avram was, let's enter into judgment. Let's enter into din. I have a din Torah against you. I have a complaint. Let Hashem be the judge. When she said that, effectively what she was saying was, let din be an operative force, and let's see who's right and who's wrong. Because she said those words, Hashem judged her with din, and as great a woman as Sarah Imenu, as almost perfect as she was, when judged with din, lost 28 years of her life, because there's that much exactness, that much demanding in din, and therefore even Sarah Imenu was held responsible and accountable for things that she didn't do, things that she could have done, and she lost 28 years of her life. I believe that this concept is very, very imperative to understanding life and understanding much of our relationship with Hashem. Many times when we daven, we ask Hashem for mercy. We ask Hashem to have rachmanis. Not that I've changed, not that the actions that I've done change, but Hashem, please judge my actions more with a system of mercy. Introduce mercy into the equation. Introduce rachamim. I may not have changed. My actions may not have changed, but as the system of judgment changes, then everything changes. And this balance between din and rachamim is always in operation. And much of what we do in terms of davening, much of what we ask Hashem for, is to introduce more rachamim, more mercy into the equation.